Hey everyone, I'm Giz, and this is the woman.
Oh, yeah. I thought I was supposed to say something.
Yeah, you were meant to say your name.
No.
Today is the first of a series that I think we're going to call something like Tough Topics or Tough Talks or something. We'll work it out. Essentially, it's two people having a conversation about really tough topics, whether it be God, religion, suicide. Today we're talking about justified murder. And if you were to talk to this to someone else, maybe in just regular society, just a friend, they might consider it a tough topic or a tough conversation. Today, we're going to do that for you. So, yeah, if you want to be a part of the conversation, then please discuss in the comment section below. I'd like to say a big thank you to all the Patreon supporters over at patreon.com/GizEdwards. For a single dollar a month, they're able to get exclusive content, including access to the audio version of this 6 days before it's Ed, apart from this one, because this is the first one. Besides from that, if you want to be a part of the Gizzards, then head over to patreon.com/GizEdwards.
Hello. I have my own fans?
You don't have your own fans. You do. You have your own hashtag.
I will have my own fans. I want a name for them. Comments, think of a name for the woman.
The woman's.
That's
the women.
The women. That's dreadful. That's just people.
That's just
it's just half the population.
Yeah.
Which aren't my fans.
They're not your fans.
They could be.
No, they're not.
Oh, yeah.
No one is. No one is your fan.
You sound like Chancellor Palpatine.
Yeah. Something complete. Anyway. Justified murder.
Mm-hmm.
Is there such a thing?
Well, we discussed yesterday a little bit, and I think both of us have the idea that it's not a thing, but I'm going to be the opposite to you for conversation sake.
And what is my stance on it, I think, is...
And I'm going to represent everybody who believes it is justified. You can, you know, have justified murder, and you're going to say, argue against me, why not?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been doing a lot of research this morning, so...
Were you?
Oh, yeah.
See, this is why you're one step ahead of me, because I just have moral on my side. So I suppose the first thing we should do is probably describe what justified murder really is. I see justified murder as killing someone through your beliefs that it's right, or that because they've done something terrible, that killing them means that it's all right to do so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think, well, if you break down both words, what murder is, the taking the act of some or some creatures or somebody's sentient life, like on purpose. And justified, I'm not sure what the Oxford Dictionary is saying, but if you justify something, it means you have a belief that's so strong that it is, yes, morally right. I probably got that wrong, but
no, that sounds about right.
But I think when you think about, like, if you're going to go by justified murder, we said this yesterday, there is a sort of discussion you can have about people who are vegetarian or vegan. Like, they'll have the thing that you know, killing animal is murder. So for people who are, you know, omnivores like we are, that we're committing justified murder on a daily, minute basis. I'm not sure how many animals are killed minutely.
Oh, minute. I thought this was to say about me, killing animals per the
just,
minute.
Just all the
how
time.
Much bacon do you think I eat?
But, like, people do. And are they committing justified murder?
See, I don't see justified murder in that sense, where you have it as an animal. Justified murder, in my eyes, is when you're killing another human being. That's murder in my eyes. Justified or not, murder is between two people rather than, you know.
Yeah. But you have to think about that discussion if you're thinking about calling justified murder, because that's not what murder is as a... I don't think murder just relates to people.
Really?
Yeah.
I see it as just people.
I like to say that this is me going against what you're saying.
What would you say?
I think murder is the act of deliberately killing another another being.
Mm-hmm.
So whether you consider animals beings or anything else that are, like, alive, that's murder. That's a creature who has the same sort of... It can breathe, it can reproduce, it can do these sort of things.
I understand what you're saying.
We're animals, so
speak for yourself.
we're animals. We're not different, really, apart from being a bit cleverer and be able to walk on two hind legs. And some cats can do that. I've seen it. So.
Okay. Well.
That's kind of a bit of a diversion there.
If we were to get rid of the cat stuff and we just talk about murder as in between two people, mm-hmm. do you ever think that there's a situation in which you are quite rightly in your own ability, morally speaking, to be able to kill someone else?
Yeah, I think if there's a direct threat to your life and or your family's life, or something you really care about's life, and that they were going to kill you and they have no qualms about killing you, then yeah, I think it's more, is justified murder self-defense?
I want to wear some headphones like you, but all I've got are these earphones. We came up with this argument before in which we said, if somebody came onto your property and started threatening you and your family, and the only thing that you had to defend yourself was a gun for some reason, mm-hmm. Would it be justified if they were about to attack your family and then you just like parried that attack and shot them in the face?
Yeah, and you said no, because you think you just incapacitate them.
Yeah, I think that there are other ways that you can incapacitate someone rather than just straight up murdering them.
Yeah, well, I think, but I don't know, we were saying, like, I think we shouldn't have had the discussion yesterday because we're talking about topics you already talked about, but like, if there was a murder out there and if they were driven to kill people, driven to kill anybody, incapacitate them wouldn't stop them. If people have that much drive, they would either get something else to help them or they would still somehow do it. Whether it means, like, through, unless you, like, cut their vocal cords, because people can be talked into killing people, can't they?
Yeah, I suppose.
And people can be talked into killing themselves. So, like, you know, you could bully somebody online or whatever so much that they kill themselves because you've caused that.
Yeah, I get that. But, okay, let's just throw, like, Oscar Pistorius out there.
Let's do it. Just throw him out there.
Just throw him out there. Yeah. So he thought an intruder came into his house. Whether or not he was right is a different story. But he thought an intruder came into his house and then...
Become a rap video or something.
Yeah, he started a rap video. He saw that someone was in his house and then he thought, oh, I'd best get my gun and shoot them.
Mm.
Now, in his mind, if that were the case, like just say that blank statement story, because I'm assuming that's happened loads of times all over the world. But I'm still thinking of brap. would that be justified? Because somebody came into your house, they intruded your house, and they would try and kill you. So you would want to kill them.
Mm-hmm.
There's also, you remember Gavin Free and Meg Turney?
Yes.
They had that intruder?
Oh, the intruder, yeah, that nearly got them.
Nearly got them. What if Gavin Free had a gun? Or Meg Turney, because she's American.
But I think that it would be that, I don't know, because that's different laws. Like, I'm sure, I don't know where the Oscar Soros thing was, I don't know if it was in South Africa or was it in the US, I'm not really sure where it was based.
No, I'm not sure.
Because she was South African. But, and Gavin Free, they've got different gun laws than we have in the UK.
But it's irrelevant with the gun laws because we're talking about justified murder.
Yeah.
I suppose the law of man doesn't really make a difference when it's...
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, do you think that there are some people out there who are deserved of justified murder? Like, is there people there
death row.
Who can't be redeemed? Like, death row, because it's been, you know, people are held there for years and years, but there's still people who have been released from death row because they found out different, you know, parts of the case years on.
Yeah, I understand that.
Like, do you think rapists or paedophiles or whatever, do you think they should be killed?
No.
Okay.
No, I don't. It often makes me cringe as well when I look on like Facebook or something and a paedophile or a rapist has been killed or beaten or, you know, whatever. And I think, well, yeah, he's done a pretty crap thing, but it doesn't mean that he deserves, like, because again, it's even though it's not murder, like say someone got beaten up in prison,
mm-hmm.
it's not murder, but it's like somebody thinks that, oh, I can justify this by just because of him being a horrible person. I don't think that somebody, no matter how bad the crime is, should be killed for it.
Yeah. I think I was reading this thing about Harold Shipman, because I was reading a book about doctors, and he hung himself in a cell, I think possibly 2 months after he was arrested for, I think, 15 life sentences.
Yeah.
He had to do one after the other, so he couldn't have got arrested. But it was weird, because people were... There was a sort of a half-weird celebration, but there wasn't one, because the families of his victims said that he killed himself, he didn't serve any time.
Mm.
You know, he got out easy from what they've had to go through, and they couldn't celebrate it. Even the fact that he was dead, which is what they wanted, they still didn't think he had his sort of just dessert.
Yeah.
So do you think that with justified murder, people are taken away, like people's things are taken away?
The time that they could serve.
The punishment.
The punishment doesn't match the crime.
Yeah.
Because you need to atone for what you've done.
Yeah.
And killing them death row style just isn't really punishment for you're just ending a life. And then you get to that whole moral bit where it's like, well, if I can end a life, like say I'm a prison guard or something, and I can end the life of somebody, does that mean that because I pulled the switch and the electric chair went off or whatnot, or I'm the guy who injected someone, how is that any different?
Mm.
Like morally? Like, because you just killed someone as well?
But our morals are also based on the things that we've learned and also the culture that we've lived in.
Yeah, I understand that.
Like, there's a thing like heaven and hell.
Mm.
You know, the bad people go down to hell. So,
which we will be talking about in a future episode.
But would that mean that, say, we kill just by murder? We killed because we thought we were right. By sort of Christian teachings, we'd still go down to hell, even though we did something that we thought was right. Therefore, we should have gone, feel that we should go to heaven because we, you know, did something that we thought was morally right, but actually isn't. That's only what Christians say. I'm not sure the last bit.
Yeah, I understand that as well. But I'm still siding with the fact that there's no such thing as justified murder. We can be more, what's the word?
I don't know what you're trying to...
We can be more creative with punishment.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, yeah. I think there's that. I'm just going to turn your thing up a little bit.
But also, if you're saying you could be more creative punishment of people who are actually atoning to their sins,
yeah,
are you doing something worse than killing them outright? Like, if you could punish them but do it horrifically, so they just, you know, they atone and do it for years and years and years, is that worse than just killing them? Is prolonged torture?
I wouldn't say torture. I didn't say creative.
You did say creative.
I said creative, but I didn't mean creative as in we can start chopping body parts off. Because that's bad. I don't know if we're ever going to come to a conclusion about this. Because, well...
But also, like I said yesterday, we aren't parents. We don't know what it's like to have a family member who has been... Like, for example, like I said yesterday, that Olympic gymnastic... person.
Yeah, the coach.
The coach and their father of one of the girls tried to beat him up in court.
Mm.
And so that like proved a sort of very like physical reaction to sort of hatred. We've never had anything like that. We've never had somebody we've known close by, like a family member or friends who everything like that, who've had such horrific things that we want to kill the person who did it.
Yeah.
So could, you know, we don't really know if what our body, what we would go to either.
No, that's very true. Okay, I'm going to throw this one out here for you then.
Uh-huh.
What about... This is kind of linking into a different topic that we're going to talk about in the future, which is time travel. What if you could time travel back in time to the crib of baby Hitler and shoot him in the face?
Like in Deadpool?
He didn't do it in Deadpool. He was gonna.
Oh.
They cut it.
See, that's tough because... From a historical standpoint, Hitler did a lot of really good things for Germany.
Yeah.
Like, stupidly good things. He brought them out of hyperinflation and stuff.
Yeah.
And as a chancellor, he was a really good chancellor, and he sort of made Germany, he helped make Germany to what it is today.
Mm.
So from a country that was completely floundering on the bank of, like, people starving in the streets and having no money, having no support from other governments because of World War One and stuff like that.
Yeah.
He did good things with that, but then obviously because of the whole Final Solution, the Holocaust, you've got a kind of flip side. But it's weird because beforehand, before I learned all the stuff about Hitler when I did my A-level about Hitler's rise to power, I would have said yeah straight away. But because of what he did to Germany, I'm kind of torn now, which is a weird thing to say. Because obviously the Holocaust was horrific and I wouldn't wish it on anybody. And if there was a way to stop him doing that, then yeah, I would say I'd go back. And if there was a thing put in place saying, oh, we can, you know, so to have this thing with Hitler, and he would, or there was a politician who was in the ranks waiting and did the same thing as Hitler, like help bring Germany out of the Weimar Republic and things like that, and he helped build Germany, but then he didn't have the Holocaust. I was like, yeah, go and kill him.
Mm.
But we don't know. I feel like I'm going to be hated for this.
Nah, I don't think
I
will.
I am.
Nah.
I'm not saying Hitler was a good guy. Please don't think that I am a Nazi.
She is a Nazi.
What do you think?
I think you're a Nazi.
I'm good.
I think, no, I couldn't. But then again, this is also like tied into my whole thing about time travel, which is quite difficult, because if you were to kill baby Hitler, how would that change the future? Would there be like another little brother of Hitler?
Yeah.
Who was
Franz.
Franz Hitler. And he just went on the murder spree. But I still wouldn't do it.